Morning children, welcome back to your chemistry class. So today in the chapter of electrolysis we are going to do the last part of it, that is the applications of electrolysis. So what are the different applications of electrolysis? The different applications of electrolysis could be like electroplating with metals, okay, then electro refining of metals, and lastly it is extraction of metals, which is also called as electrometallurgy. These are the three applications of electrolysis that we need to study. So let us begin with the electroplating first and understand what is electroplating. Electroplating, it is a process in which a very thin film of metal, maybe gold, silver or nickel, they get deposited on another inferior metallic article with the help of electricity. This is called as electroplating. What did I say? It is a process in which a thin film of metal like gold, silver, nickel, copper, etc. gets deposited, okay, on another inferior metallic article. With the help of electricity. Okay, so what are the reasons for electroplating? Reasons of electroplating could be maybe for the decoration purpose, for decorating articles, right? For example, like brass objects, they are plated with silver to give them a shiny appearance and giving a beauty of the silver to the particular article. Then even to sometimes protect from rusting and corrosion, to protect from rusting and corrosion, like for example your iron articles, they easily get rusted in the presence of moisture and the air, so they can be protected by electroplating. Maybe zinc over it, so iron will be an inferior metal and zinc becomes the superior metal, and when zinc is electroplated over iron, it is always termed as galvanizing, right, to protect the iron from getting rusted. So what are the different conditions? Now let us understand what are the conditions for electroplating. This is very, very important. If we understand the conditions, then electroplating will be very simple. So remember, the article to be electroplated is always should be your cathode. First point, the article to be electroplated is always cathode. Okay, why cathode? Why? Because metal is always deposited where? At cathode, by the gain of electrons. So your article should always, that is to be electroplated, should always be your cathode. Second point, the metal to be plated, right, on the article is always made the anode. For example, you want to electroplate a spoon. So spoon is the article that you want to electroplate, so that should be attached to your cathode. okay. Now the spoon has to be electroplated, say with copper, so that copper should be always your anode. So what did I say? That the metal to be plated, okay, on the article is always made the anode. So over here copper will be your anode, or the strip of copper will be the anode, right? Now why is it so? Because the metal anode, it will continuously dissolve, right, as the ions in the solution, and they will be replaced periodically where towards the cathode. Now third important point, the electrolyte, that is the solution in which you dip your cathode and your anode, that solution which allows electricity to pass through should definitely contain that particular metallic ion with which you want to electroplate your article. Clear? So the electrolyte must contain ions of the metal which is to be electroplated. Clear? Why? Because the electrolyte dissociates into ions of the metal and they will migrate towards the cathode, and there they will get neutral and get deposited over your article. Clear? Then fourth point over here, that low current is always preferred. Preferred is what? Low current. Why low current is preferred? Because higher current, it causes very uneven distribution or accumulation of the metal on the article. Therefore low current is preferred over here. And the fifth important point is that direct current and not AC current should be used over here. Direct current should be used and not AC current, right? Why not AC current? Because AC current causes discharge and ionization to alternate at the cathode and thus giving no effective coating over it. So we do not agree with AC current. We always go ahead with DC current or direct current. I hope all these five conditions you have understood. If you have understood these five conditions, then electroplating will go very fast. So let us do certain examples for electroplating. So one example could be electroplating spoon with silver. Okay, what did I say? We have to electroplate spoon with silver. So first and foremost, see the figure that you have to draw. So this is your electrolyte. This is your electrolytic cell in which you contain, this is the electrolyte. Okay, now what did I say? You need to have two electrodes. You have to electroplate a spoon. So spoon should be your cathode. So let me draw a spoon over here. So suppose this is your spoon and you have to electroplate it with a silver. So this is your silver electrode. So they have to be connected with the battery. So this is your cathode. So cathode is your negative electrode and this is your anode. So try to understand, this is your electrolytic cell, this is your electrolyte. Now, electrolyte should contain silver. Electrolyte should contain silver. So, what should be your electrolyte over here? The electrolyte that could be chosen can be sodium argentocyanide or potassium argentocyanide. So, it can be sodium. This can be sodium argentocyanide. Okay, what is the name of this? This is sodium argentocyanide. Okay, or you can take potassium argentocyanide. Now, what is this? This is your anode. And your anode is the positive electrode. So, this anode is made up of what? Silver. Got it? This is your cathode. And what is this cathode? This is your spoon, the article that you want to electroplate. This is what? Your battery. Clear? So, is this figure clear to you? Now, let us understand. The electrolyte that we are using over here is your sodium argentocyanide or NaAgCN whole twice. What are the ions present over here? So, ions are your sodium ions, your silver ion, cyanide ion is there, then your hydrogen ion is there, hydroxyl ion is there. So, these are the ions that are present in the electrolyte. Clear? Now, let us see what happens at cathode and what happens at anode. So, let's do cathode this side and anode over here. So, now let's see which ions are going to move towards cathode. Towards cathode, all the positive ions are going to move. So, sodium ion, silver ion and hydrogen ion. But out of all these three, which one is going to get the preference? Look over here, sodium is placed very much above in the electrochemical series and silver is placed below hydrogen. So, who gets the preference? Silver gets the preference over here. So, silver, since it gets the preference over here, it is going to accept one electron and become neutral. Is that clear? So, what happens at cathode? What did I say? That the positive charges, they move towards the electrode, they gain electron and they become neutral. Okay? Now, let's see what happens at anode. What ions are going to move at anode? Cyanide ion is going to move and hydroxide ions are going to move. But remember, what is anode made up of? Anode is made up of silver. So, preference will be given to the active electrode, not to these ions. So, since your anode is an active electrode, therefore, over here, silver is going to lose one electron and it is going to release silver ions in the electrolyte, which again are going to move towards the cathode, gain electron and become neutral. Is this point clear? So, the process continues over here. What will happen? The process will continue. The silver ions, they get attracted to the spoon and here they gain electron and they become atoms of the silver which deposit on the spoon and this spoon forms a, at low current, it forms a thin firm coating over it. Okay. So, the thickness of the coating will always depend upon what? The duration of the current. What did I say? It should be low current. What kind of current is required? AC or DC? DC current is required over here. Okay. And now what happens to the electrolyte? The electrolyte solution, it maintains the same concentration. Why? And if it is colored here, since it is silver, you will not find much color over here. But the iron still remain in the electrolyte. Why so? Because this anode is continuously releasing ions in the electrolyte. Is that clear? So the concentration of the ions will remain there found in the electrolyte at the end of the experiment. Spoon, it is taken out and it is washed several times with water, dried, and it is polished. So this is what we get, the electroplated spoon with silver. I hope this is very clear to you. Simple, no? Now, all these ions, like for example, sodium ion, your hydrogen ion, your cyanide ion, your hydroxyl ions, what are they termed as now? They are called as spectator ions, because they were just visualizing or seeing what was happening over there. They had no work over there at the electrodes, right? So they are termed as spectator ions. So this was all about electroplating spoon with silver. What did you observe over here? What did we observe? We saw that over the spoon, the cathode is becoming thicker with the thin film coating of silver, and this anode electrode was becoming thinner because the anode silver was releasing ions continuously into the electrolyte. I hope this is clear. We next move to another example of electroplating. Second example could be electroplating a thin strip with nickel. Okay, so let's see how can we do that. So you have to first draw the diagram. This is your electrolytic cell. Then you have the electrolyte. What should your electrolyte contain? It should contain nickel. So let us take this electrolyte as nickel sulfate. Then we need the electrodes over here. So thin strip. So thin strip is the article that we want to electroplate. So that should be your cathode. So I take a thin strip over here and this is my cathode, and then my anode, what it should be? It should be my nickel anode. So this is attached, they are attached to the battery. This is attached to the negative end, this is attached to the positive end. What is this? This is your battery. This is your anode, which is made up of what? Nickel. Okay. What is this? This is your cathode. And what is your cathode? It is your thin strip. Followed. So what is your electrolyte now? Your electrolyte is nickel sulfate solution. So what are the ions present in the electrolyte? We have nickel ions, we have sulfate ions, we have hydrogen ions, we have hydroxyl ions. So let us see now what happens at cathode and what happens at anode. Okay, so cathode, nickel ion is going to go here, then hydrogen ion is also going to move towards cathode. At anode, we will find sulfate ions and hydroxide ions. So over here, nickel or hydrogen, who is going to get the preference? Nickel will get the preference because it is found lower than hydrogen over here. Then nickel ion is going to accept two electrons and it is going to become neutral and get deposited where? On the thin strip. Now look at the anode. Anode we have sulfate and the hydroxyl ions, but anode is made up of what? Nickel, which is an active electrode. Therefore, these become the spectator ions, and over here, nickel is going to lose two electrons and become nickel ion and move into the electrolyte. Is this point clear? So over here, what? Your hydrogen ion, your sulfate ion and your hydroxide ions. What are these? These are your spectator ions, right? They only had to migrate towards the anode and cathode, but they did not show any action over there. So they were just acting as spectator ions over here. So article was plated with what? Your nickel, right? And what have you observed? On the thin strip, there is a thick coating, and whereas your pure nickel anode, it has become a thin rod of anode. What do we know about the solution? The solution still has the concentration of the nickel ions present in it. Why so? Because anode is made up of pure nickel metal, which is continuously losing electrons and going where? Into the electrolyte. So I hope you have understood how to show the different reactions about electroplating the inferior metal with the other superior metals. Now next we come to electro refining of metals. Let us understand what do we mean by electro refining. Electro refining, it is a process by which the metals which contain impurities, they are purified electrolytically to give a pure metal. Okay, so purification of the metal in short can be termed as electro refining. So over here, copper should be one of the most important example over here, because copper is used in the form of wire for electric transmission. And do you know that copper, if it contains even 0.2% of impurity, it will definitely reduce its conductivity to a great extent. Therefore, all the copper that is required in the electrical purpose, it should always be pure copper. So pure copper can only be obtained by electro refining that particular metal over here. So what is the electrolyte that is required? The electrolyte should be the solution of copper sulfate. So what are the ions present then in the solution? It should be copper ion, sulfate ions, hydrogen ions and the hydroxyl ions. Clear? Now let us look what happens at cathode and what happens at anode, right? So before moving that, what is cathode made up of and what is anode made up of? Over here I would like to show you a rough figure, though my drawing is not very good. We take a long tank in which number of cathodes and anodes are placed together so that number of wires they get electro refined. So I take pure cathode thin rods are taken. These are cathode. Okay, I'm writing it down over here. Cathode, pure copper rods are they, right? And they can be connected together and attached to the battery, right? Then we take impure anodes. Anodes are impure copper metal, okay? Anodes are What are these? These are anodes. Okay, they are impure copper metals. So they are also taken and attached to the battery, right? So these are the positive electrodes, anode, and this is your negative electrode. Got it? And now let us see what is the electrolyte. Electrolyte, as I told you, it should be your copper sulfate. What is this? Your copper sulfate solution, which is the electrolyte. And what is this? This is your electrolytic cell, in which the process of electrolysis takes place. And this is your battery. Okay. So now what happens? What did I say? What is your cathode? Cathode is your pure copper metal. Copper, it is your pure copper metal, right? And what is anode? Anode is your impure copper. That is this, right? Now what will happen? At cathode, they will accept electron and form neutral metal deposition. What will happen at anode? It is going to lose electrons and copper ions will be formed in the electrolyte. The electrolyte will become what color? Blue solution. When the current is passed, what are we going to see? Through the electrolyte, the copper ions of the copper sulfate solution, they are attracted to the cathode. All these ions or whatever is present in the electrolyte, so they are attracted to the cathode, where they gain electrons and they get deposited on the pure copper strip. The impure copper, it loses electron and passes into the solution as the soluble copper ions, right? Now what are we going to see over here in this figure? That the copper ions, they are migrating to the cathode in the form of a procession, and after gaining electrons from it, they get deposited where? At cathode. So the net result is that the impure slab of copper, which is the impure slab of copper, the anode, it is getting pure, right? And this is becoming a thin strip of pure copper, right? And the pure cathode, which was a thin strip earlier, is now becoming a thick strip. So when the impure copper, it is going to lose electrons, what will happen? They will become thin. They start becoming thinner. Okay? They start becoming thinner. And what happens? Where is the impurity going? It is settling at the bottom. So what is this then called as? This is called as anode mud. Okay? The impurity settles down at the bottom, which is impure or anode mud. So your anode is becoming a thin strip, which was earlier a thick strip. And what is happening to cathode? The cathodes, they are becoming a thick strip because pure deposition of the copper is taking place on these electrodes. Get my point? So at the end, what happened? We obtain pure copper electrodes, whether it is at anode or it is at cathode, because cathode was earlier pure thin strip, it has now become pure thick strip, and the impure anode, all the impurity has settled down at the bottom, and we obtain thin strip of pure copper at anode as well. Did you understand? So over here, the copper deposited at cathode is about 99.99% pure copper after electrolysis. So after the electrolysis is over, these strips, the thin and the thick strips, now they are melted and they are transformed into desired shapes. Is that clear? So this is the way how the metals can be refined, or they can be purified from any impurity. So electrorefining of metal is also done over here. Now lastly we come to electrometallurgy. What is electrometallurgy? It is the process of extraction of metals by the process of electrolysis, right? So metals which are always higher in the electrochemical series, like for example your potassium, sodium, calcium and till aluminium, they all can be extracted by the process of electrolysis. So let us take first example to extract potassium. So the electrolyte, right, could be a fused potassium bromide. Now when I say fused potassium bromide, so let us see the reaction what we have. Let us see the reaction. So KBr on electrolysis is going to give us KIon, KIon plus Br minus. Now what, let us see what happens at cathode and what happens at anode. So which ion is going to move towards, now there is no solution over here, it is a fused state, melted form, so no hydrogen or hydroxide ions are present here, right? So cathode, which ion is going to move? Potassium ions are going to move, and anode, bromine ions are going to move. Okay, so now over here potassium is going to accept one electron and it is going to form pure potassium over here. Over here bromine is going to lose one electron and from bromine, number of such bromine combined to form bromine gas. So over here what are we going to observe? Reddish brown fumes can be seen over here, where releasing from anode. Reddish brown fumes can be observed releasing from anode. Okay, another example, this was example number one. Let's see another example of, say, fused sodium chloride. Okay, so reaction for fused sodium chloride would be NaCl gives us Na plus plus Cl minus. So let's see what happens at cathode and what happens at anode. Okay, cathode, sodium ion is going to move, anode, chloride ion is going to move. Sodium ion is going to accept one electron and form neutral sodium. Okay, and what will happen at anode? It is going to lose one electron and become chlorine atom. Number of chlorine atoms combine to give chlorine gas. What kind of a gas? Greenish yellow gas can be seen where? At anode, right? So I hope you have understood what is electrometallurgy. Also we can go ahead using magnesium chloride also, or even you can do this for aluminium oxide and so on. Try doing the electro extraction of metals by the process of electrolysis as I have shown. So with this we finish off with the chapter. Thank you.